Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. There's been a lot of talk about not getting the full value of a rated SPF from a sunscreen simply because people don't put enough sunscreen on. So the question is, how much sunscreen do you need to use in order to get true protection from the SPF? And today we're just talking about traditional carbon-based sunscreens, not the chem-free sunscreens with the zinc and the titanium. So the amount of sunscreen that you need to use for your entire body, assuming you're at the beach and you're just wearing a bathing suit, is about an ounce in order to get the actual SPF value. Let me show you what an ounce looks like. All four of these containers are all 1 ounce containers. I'm going to put 1 ounce of sunscreen into this container. I know it seems like a lot of sunscreen, but that is what 1 ounce of sunscreen looks like. That's what it takes to adequately cover your body. And by the way, this is a 5 ounce tube of sunscreen, which means you're only going to get 5 applications out of this. Okay, so what happens if you don't use the right amount of sunscreen? For instance, what happens if you just use 1/2 ounce of sunscreen? Well, let me show you what 1/2 ounce looks like. Certainly you would think that you would get a lot of sun protection from this amount of sunscreen, but actually an SPF of 50 becomes an SPF of 7 if you haven't used the full ounce. And an SPF of 15 goes all the way down to 4. All right, for the moment, let's just assume you're not going to the beach, you're going to work. It's a spring day and the sun is out. The only thing that's not covered by clothing is your face and neck. How much do you need to cover your face and neck to get the true protection? You actually need an amount of sunscreen that's about the size of 1/4 or 1/3 to 1/2 of a teaspoon. And that's what you need for your face and neck. If you use these amounts of sunscreen, you will get the full value, the full protection of the SPF. But remember, you also have to reapply your sunscreen after you swim, after you perspire, and every 2 to 3 hours. In about 2 weeks, I'll show you the amount of chem-free sunscreens that you need to apply to get the full value and full protection of those. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.